Welcome to Light of God International Miracle Center. Light of God International Miracle Center. As a prophetic ministry, Light of God Ministry has been used by the Lord not only to preach the gospel to all nations, but also to transform lives by reaching out to the needy, the poor, the sick, the weak, the depressed, and many more. Be blessed as you listen to this life-transforming message by the anointed servant of God. Your faith shall be built up and your miracle delivered.
Bless you. We welcome all the newcomers, all those that are coming to worship with us for the first time. I'm telling you, this is a house of mercy. You will go, you will find mercy and favor will go home with you. There are so many angels here worshiping with us. Amen. A topic on faith. But today is your faith can grow. Your faith can grow. Tell somebody you can grow your faith. Amen. Because when we're young, we are not taught that we need to do something about our faith. So we just thought all we need to do is to pray and believe. We thought we can just ask if God did not do it, then we said maybe God did not hear us, our prayer. But I want you to know that you have to grow your faith to be able to get what you need from God. As much as your faith grows, that's how you tap from God. If there is electricity available here, it depends on the cable that I use. If I want to connect to air conditioner, right? I'm not going to use the same cable I am going to use to connect to Bob. If your faith is small, then a small thing will be happening in your life. If you want big faith, because electricity is available. It depends on you, the kind of cable you use. That's what determines the amount of current you are going to get. You didn't develop your faith, you want 10 million. You have not even started from $10 or faith for going out and coming in. If you don't, let me tell you, when you grow your faith and we're going to use the word of God, you will see that your faith needs to grow. As big as your faith is, that's how you can get something from God. Because the Bible says it is impossible to please God. It's not possible to get anything from God, but it's possible by faith you get everything from God. And you cannot get something from God if your faith remains a little faith. Some people, Jesus even asked his disciples, say, where is your faith? That means if you are not careful, you can be given faith because everybody is given. You can hide your own and be working on another person's faith. Some of you, you're still depending on your pastor's faith. Are you there with me? But today I come to tell you that you have faith, but grow your own faith. Faith is not about head. Faith is not about common sense. Faith is about the heart. Hello? I hope you are with me. I pray that the Spirit of God, as I speak, the word will become like sharp sword. It will enter your spirit. You will know that where you are is not where God wants you to be. That God has a big plan for you. You are not, God is not at fault over your case. You are the one at fault. You cannot sit down. It's just like if we are eating food. If I keep eating and going to sleep, my body will be developing. But the fat, I will look flabby if I don't exercise. You understand what I'm saying? If I don't exercise, I'll be getting fat. Likewise, your faith. If you don't use your faith, if you don't grow it, you can't go anywhere. The Bible says, have faith. Let's look at somewhere. Surely that's not where I'm supposed to stop. Because we are jealous of others. Why is this woman giving testimony? Why is this woman or this man being used? You are complaining. You are looking at people that are using their faith. You say, maybe I don't have no faith. We will see whether you are not giving yours. And you are going to tell me where you put your own. And how far you have walked your own. Then we know why things are not working. Because God is a rewarder of good things. Amen? So if God says, without faith we cannot please him, then there's nothing we can do than to develop that faith or ask for faith. I just want to look at Hebrew. Just want to pick up something from verse 6. Hebrew 11, verse 6. We all know it of it. It says, and without faith, it is impossible to be well pleasing unto God. Without faith, you cannot please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is. When you are coming to God, some of us believe that he is. But let's read another. It said, for he that cometh to God must believe that he is. And by faith, Noah being one of... No. What I'm saying is that, and he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. When you come to God, maybe you believe that you were, but know that there is a reward because you cannot please God until you start using your faith. I was thinking, meditating on it last night. I was thinking of Adam and Eve. I said, look at Adam and Eve. God created them. They were created by God. Everything, God made it available for them. He prepared, God, he did everything to please them. Likewise, everything on earth is for you. The Bible says the eyes of God is going to and fro. That means for what? He's looking after you. The Bible says God does not sleep, nor slumber. That means because of you, God don't sleep. He's awake 24 hours to take care of us. The Bible says everything was made for them. And he now placed them in a garden. And all he required from them, trust me, have faith in me. Everything is made by me. But you know what? Human being, that's what is happening today. By the time Satan came and deceived them, God, don't trust that man. He knows that if you do this, this will happen. If you eat this fruit, between good and you will be like him. Then they begin to say, how can I trust you, God? So because if I eat this fruit, I will be like you. That's why God, we'll go ahead and eat it. They begin to lose that trust. That's our problem. And they ended up leaving the presence of God. Sometimes you pray. You don't believe that God has answered you. And Satan will step in and say, if God will do it for you, he could have done it. He can do it, but don't you see he did it for Stephen and did it for Jonathan and did it for them, and he didn't do it for you. God don't love you. God don't even listen to you. And before you know it, the trust, you kill the trust. And all that God asks you is just, you cannot please me. That was what happened. The fall of man initially. And that must not, God hates that. He doesn't want you to fall. He said, all you need is just have faith in me. Without faith, you cannot please me. They couldn't please God because they refused. He will come at the cool of the day to play with them. Still, they are still looking for something that is not missing. God said, trust me. I made everything because of you. I came, I left my throne because of you. I came into this world. I died because of you. I don't sleep because of you. I'm protecting you. No matter the road you are going, I am there with you. No matter how low you are today, he knows how to take you up. He said, promotion don't come from nobody. If you can focus on him, promotion cometh from him. Are you there with me? It's only God that can promote you. And that's why we need faith to please him. So if you want to please God, you have to trust him. That means you have to have faith in him. And you have to develop your faith. Hallelujah. Because when you look at it, let us look at the Ephesians 2:8. From today, you will start using your faith. You will use it in Jesus' name. Ephesians 8. Ephesians 2, 8 to 10. Ephesians 2, 8. This is what it says. It says, for by grace have you been saved through faith. So, our prayer, without faith, your prayer cannot be answered. Without faith, if you are fasting, you are fasting in vain. Without faith, nothing. The Bible says even your salvation. If you say you are born again today, your salvation is through faith. So there is nothing you can receive in the kingdom where we belong, which is the kingdom of God, without faith. And that's why we keep saying that the currency we spend in this kingdom is the currency of faith. You have to trust God. Don't trust in what your common sense or your eyes is or your senses. Don't trust on what surrounds you. Sometimes things that looks rough. The Bible says, until there is a turning of the water, stirring of the water until it happens. Before a testimony, somebody will drop in and be healed. There is always a bowl of Bethesda around us. That when testimony is about to come forth, testimony that will bring many to the kingdom, there will be a storm around you. There will be a stirring of pool of Bethesda in your life. And you'll be wondering, where is this taking me to? But in every storm, there's a testimony. I said, in every storm, if you stand still, you will see the salvation of the Lord. No matter where you are today, no one knows where you are going to. You don't even know where you are going to. Oh, he said, take your cross. And he said, follow me. He said, your step will be ordered by God. I will order your steps. He said, when you are passing through the water, I am in there. He said, why are you afraid? When you pass through the storm, I am there. He said, why are you afraid? You must have lost something that is precious to you. And you think it's over in life. But I come to tell you today, it's not over. All that you've been through is to mature you. All that you have been through is for you to be able to handle the riches and the blessings and the power of God that is coming your way. Yeah, by the time God finishes with you, they will celebrate you. I said it again, they will celebrate you. You will be celebrated. The Bible says it is the gift of God. That means faith is the gift of God. So you have to receive the gift. God has given it to you, but you have to cherish it. You don't need to hide it or keep it, because some people receive, like the one that received a talent and went and hid it and waiting. But now you're sharing up those that are using their own. But where is your own? The gift of faith, where is your own? You cannot live in this kingdom of God where we are without faith. It's impossible. You can enjoy all the riches Because we have the fullness of Christ in us. You can only enjoy it when you develop your faith. The Bible said in somewhere in the book of, let's look at the book of Romans 12. Romans 12. Hallelujah. Are you all there? Romans 12, verse 3. It said, "For I said through the grace that was given me to everyone that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than they ought to, but to think as to think soberly, according as God has dealt to each man a measure of faith." It's not about big man. It's not about pastors. It's not about nobody. The Bible says everybody. If you are giving 10 grams or you are giving 30 grams, I am giving 30 grams. You are giving 30 grams, everybody is giving 30 grams. Of it. I'm just using that as an illustration. But it's not left for you what you do with yours. If you want it to increase, it's left for you. To increase it, it is left for you because as we go on, you will know that faith can increase. The Bible told us about different kind of faith. It said there's a little faith, there is a strong faith, there is a weak faith. You think about yourself. Which one do you have? And there is a rich faith, great faith, all kinds of faith. But they all started from little faith. You start somewhere and start growing it. And start developing your faith. And you cannot develop your faith except through the word of God. The food of faith is the word of God. The food of faith. If you are not giving your faith enough food, the Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. If you don't give your faith enough food, when you need that faith, the faith will be sleeping. That's why you have to look for a bishop. That's why you know other people that they are born, you are the same human being like you. You'll be looking for power that is hot up and down. While you are giving the same measure of faith, they go develop their own. Develop their own. And they are using it, and everybody will go to stadium and watch them. I will develop my own faith. Tell somebody you will develop your own faith. Hello. Amen. We have to develop our faith. Because faith determines how far you will go in life. That's it. If your faith cannot carry a small, she was saying it that no job, nothing, and she went and bought a brand new car. You think it's easy to exercise that kind of faith? It will look crazy to some of us sitting down here. You say, "Are you okay?" I remember the day she told me, "Say, Mom, my car. Mom, do you think I can go and if they will, I will get a good car?" I mean, "Oh, they asked me to get a new car." Said, "You have the faith?" He said, "Yes." "Okay, use your faith. Let's see." Because your faith, you will think it will disappoint you. No. Faith will never disappoint. But it's hard. Initially, you'll be running here and there. And sometimes you feel as if your heart will be beating. But just keep on going. You will make it. You will make it. If it is your school, you will make it. You marry by faith, you don't know that man. You come out, you take your key, and you are driving by faith. You don't know who is driving, the mad person that is driving around you. You drink water by faith. People drink that water, they die. Everything, you wake up and you breathe in fresh air, is by faith. You are pregnant 9 months and you are waiting to give birth and you are buying everything. By faith, you don't know. Some people, the day of delivery, they give up, they die. By faith, you sat on that seat. You are not expecting that you will fall. You just came and you sat down with all your weight. All this in life, every stage of life is by faith. But the only thing is that it depends on how far you want to go. That's how far you will grow your faith. You cannot use small faith to get something big. Hello? Are you there with me? It is well with you. In the name of Jesus, determine where you want to get to. Determine what you want to get from Christ. All you need is available. He will not give it to you until he sees faith. You stretch the currency of faith, then you can buy anything. As you are sitting down, it's not your bank account or your what you are earning that will keep you in life. It's not. It's not. I've seen a man that walk in a place, he spent all his life working, over 30-something years, just getting ready to retire. He was fired for no reason. And no retirement. No retirement. He's old, he's like, he's just 60-something and he was fired. Looking back, what it is a waste of time. But your faith, many of you by now, you're supposed to be supporting your family, spending money. You have ideas of what you want to do, but fear. And I told you, I said, Jesus said it. He said, I have not given you the spirit of fear. He said, wherever you have taken that fear from, give it back to the owner. Satan's weapon is fear. Jesus' weapon is faith. He said, I have given you sound mind. I've given you power and love. I didn't give you fear. Whatever I ask you to do, do it. It may look foolish and stupid. Say, but when you do it, you will have testimonies upon testimonies. In the name of Jesus. Let us look at one chapter in the book of 2 Thessalonians. Because you'll be wondering, how do I grow it? Yes, we'll tell you. If we didn't finish, we'll continue next time. The book of 2 Thessalonians 1 verse 4. Shout hallelujah. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1. I'll read from verse 3. This is a letter to the Thessalonians. From it said, we are bound to give thanks to God always to you, brethren, even as it is meant, for that your faith grow exceedingly. He was talking to the Thessalonians. He said, look at, your faith has grown exceedingly. Your faith has grown exceedingly. That I just want to point it out that faith can grow. That means they started somewhere, and now Paul is saying, wow. He wrote a letter to them, the Thessalonians. He said, I have seen that your faith has grown. That means continuously, your faith is growing every day, every time. Each time I appear, I can see, even from your talk, the way you talk, I can see that your faith is growing. It irritates me when people come and talk with fear. Because what we are teaching you here is to be bold and trust God and stand no matter the storm that you will make it. If I come here as your leader and so many things that has happened in this church and you see me shaking, what will you do? You are shaking and shaking and shaking. Why? What is making you shake? What is making you shake is because you refuse to eat the word. The more of the word you read, the more of the ways of God you know. You cannot know his ways when you cannot go back to him and take him in. He said they have faith. From weak faith, I can see they now have strong faith. What is it that you want to do? That you are so scared. You don't know how to do it. The Lord is telling you, believe God. Prayer and fasting alone cannot do it. Everything we do in this kingdom we are is through faith. And if you want to go far, I've told you, go back and start feeding your faith by the word of God. Say, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The more you hear the word, if you want to live a life of peace, that even when the doctor tells you something, you are not shaking. We shake as if we want to die now because we don't have the word. The word is the food of the spirit that will make you stand and you will be stable. Because I will not lie to you. The Bible says, in this world you are, there will be tribulations. That there will be trials. There will be rumors of wars. People will disappoint you and betray you. People will talk about you. You know why those petty things still troubles you? Somebody called me names. And then you sit down there. What a baby. You need pacifier? I'll give you pacifier. I'm not greeting you anymore because you talk about me. Funny. Look at yourself. Some things we are doing, if our children do it, you say, come here, I'll knock your head. Once when we now come into the house of God, there is no difference. Even the children are doing better. They are behaving better than us. We pick up everything. Some people is... I was standing with that lady. Prophet just came and greeted that lady and he greeted me. Maybe I didn't even see you. Why will I not greet you? You understand? Why will I not greet you? Who am I? I'm your servant here. When you come to this place, I'm serving you. You are sleeping, I'm praying for you. You are working any money, I am not working. I'm telling you, you don't know. I am the one serving you. So if you think I can be proud, I can be proud. I am your servant here. It's not about you. The way you look at it is that she's the head. Which head? Which head? Head is carrying everything. You dump everything on the head. I'm the garbage. Even if you're angry, I can't be angry. If you abuse me, I can't abuse you back. Even if you slap me, I say, I'm still sorry. I'm sorry. Even if I don't feel like laughing, once I see you, I must laugh. What are you saying? It's a yoke. Hello. Amen. I'll still finish. Amen. I'm telling you, please. You have to grow that faith. Say, I have faith. Amen. Say, I have to grow that faith. That I have. Because when Satan sees faith, he runs away. Where there's no faith, he will go and stay there and torment you. Before you know, you'll be hearing voices. Before you know it, he will give you because all that Satan has is evil. All that God has is good. Satan will tell you bad things. It's your father that is doing you. It's your mother that is doing you. It's your sister that is doing you. It's this that is doing you. Before you know it, he now put you into a cage. Because he wants to tell you all the people, even in the church, oh, they are doing me in the church. Because that's your way into the cage. When you now enter his cage, he lock up the cage. And he will be tormenting you. Some of you, you even enter his cage and say, nobody loves me here. Nobody will love you because you choose how you want to live. Nobody chooses that lifestyle for you. You have chosen a lifestyle that cannot pay you. It will not profit you. Choose a lifestyle that will be happy. Nothing can touch your joy. Even in your marriage, your husband cannot touch your joy. Amen? At your job place, nobody counting on petty things. You can't sleep. At night, I am thinking. Some people said, I think for 3 days. You thinking for 3 days? For what? I am telling you, you are alive. You are not sick. 3 days. And it maybe one person, Satan, use one agent to just send you a word. Just a word. Because they know that once you get that word, then you can't focus to pray. And your faith is gone. And then you start having unforgiveness. Once there's unforgiveness, everything, you shut the door. of your joy of blessings. The Lord will help us. In the name of Jesus, how do we grow this faith? I've told you, first thing is feed your faith. Feed your faith. Feed your faith. Tell somebody, feed. Point said, prophet said, I should touch your shoulder. Say, feed your faith. Amen. It's prophetess that says, so if they're angry, let them talk to me. You have to feed your faith. Feed it. Whatever you feed your life with is what you become. If I'm feeding myself with history stories, I will know a lot about the world. If I feed myself with politics, I will be the best politician. You understand? If I feed myself with medical things, I'll be the best doctor. Whatever you feed yourself with, if I feed myself a lot with food, I'll be the biggest person in America. Hallelujah. Whatever, if you feed yourself, this word of God is the word of faith. So when you keep feeding yourself with the word of God, you are feeding your faith is eating good food. Good food. I am telling you, when you keep feeding it, I am telling you, it's better than jollof rice. Are you there? It's better than that pepper soup. It's very sweet. By the time you have it in you, it becomes sweeter than honey. Hello? Tell somebody hello. Tell the person to feed yourself in the word of God. Then shout hallelujah. You see, when you look at the book of Romans, wow, God is good. Romans 10. Romans 10 verse 17. Romans 10, 17. It says, so believe, comment by hearing. Believe, faith, comment by hearing. And hearing by the word of Christ. This one says the word of Christ. So believe, when you are feeding yourself, you feed yourself by the word of God. The Bible said, it said, man does not live by bread alone. Not by bread alone. When you feed your body, another, the second thing I want to give you is exercise. Exercise your faith. You cannot feed yourself. I've been eating and eating and eating. You're hearing the word of God every day. Okay. What the next thing, you exercise what you've been hearing. I told you that if they give you food and you are eating and sitting down in one place, and they're giving us the same food, I will eat mine and go to bed. And you eat your own and go for exercise. Don't you know that? You'll be more, built. You will look stronger. You will look sharper. We're eating the same food. But if I'm taking that food, all I do is to sleep. Even when you get fat, the fat, you exercise it and use it. But when I get fat, it becomes flappy. I walk, because nothing. That's when I know that arthritis don't kill me. Hallelujah. Amen. We're not saying you are not studying the word, some of you. But do something with it. Exercise your faith. If you don't exercise it, it will not grow. It's not only in the church you can exercise it. You can exercise it anywhere. In your job place. If somebody comes to you and said, I have my grace, let's pray. Holy Spirit, you just say, in the name of Jesus, the name above every other name, you just declare and decree. We don't pray like we are begging. We're not begging. We are representing him. So you are not a beggar. You understand? You don't pray, please do this. Please do that. Please. No. You are not the one doing it. It's not about please, God should do it. You are representing him to do it. He wants to do it. He's just looking for the body that he will use to do it. So if you said I'm available, all is to use you to do it. So you now take his place and say it with authority. Hold the hands of the person and declare, I don't care. Well, if I pray for you and you say you have headache and tomorrow you come back, it's your own problem. Go develop it. Because if I'm praying for you, I'm not praying for you with any doubt in my heart. All I'm praying, I believe. So it's not left for you. What are you doing with yours? You didn't grow your own faith. You are coming to me and telling me, I should pray, you want to be a governor. I will pray, but can your faith get to that position? You understand? Are you getting what I'm saying? I'm finishing, please. I don't know, because we're still going to continue this same topic. Because we have a lot to cover in it. Are you there with me? So, you have to. We have read it in the Word that every one of us, don't tell me you don't have no faith. Some people, you say that, use your faith, say, I don't have no faith. You don't have no faith. You are in Christ Jesus. You don't. There's no way. Because the Bible said that you are all given. You don't have faith. Then how did you come out and give your life to Christ? You don't have no faith. You're going out and coming in every day. No. You have faith. Develop it. Grow your faith. It is possible. The Bible said the Thessalonians, their faith grew exceedingly. So if you want good from God, the first thing you need to do is to grow your faith. By the time you grow your faith, the house you are living before, when you enter, it will look small. There's a property we want to buy. By the time I enter, I look at the property and say, this is not faith, though. This is not faith. This is not faith. This is common sense. This is just common sense. I want the one that I will stretch faith. Please, start stretching your feet. It's not about work. It's not about it. Amen? Are you all blessed? Then jump up and shout hallelujah. Amen. Because of time, we cannot finish it. But exercise it. Feed it and then go to the gym. You understand? What do I say? Feed your faith. Say it. Say, I will feed my faith. Then I will go to the gym. That means I will go out and do something with my faith. Are you going to do that from today? No, don't refer nobody to prophetess. You are the prophetess. Go. Because when you give birth to a goat, the goat becomes goat. When you give birth to elephant, they become elephant. Give birth to a lion, they become a lion. You are the prophetess. Powerful women of God. Powerful men of God. Shout and say, we can do it. Say, I have the power of God in me. Hallelujah. You are victorious. Begin to thank God. Begin to thank God. I want to sing this song. The choir should help me. When I remember where you brought me from.
Hope you have been empowered by this message. Thank you and remain blessed.